Engine has many parameters, but some of the most important parameters are explained here. Maximum rated power, the highest power developed by an engine for short period of time. Normal rated power, the highest power developed by an engine in continuous operation. Rated speed, crankshaft rotational speed at which rated power is developed. TDC, topmost position of the piston inside cylinder of an engine. BDC, bottommost position of a piston inside cylinder of an engine. Bore, the diameter of the cylinder of an engine. Bore of the cylinder usually varies from 0.5 meters to 0.5 centimeters. Stroke, the distance through which the piston moves from TDC to BDC or BDC to TDC. If the stroke is greater than bore, then it is called undersquared engine. Similarly, if stroke is less than bore, it is called oversquared engine. And if stroke is equal to bore, we call it as a square engine. Next, clearance volume. Space or volume between top dead center and cylinder head. Swept volume or displaced volume. The volume that piston displaces or sweeps out as it moves from TDC to BDC or BDC to TDC. Next, cylinder capacity. It is equal to swept volume of each cylinder times the number of cylinders. It is known as cubic capacity of an engine. Compression ratio. It is ratio of maximum cylinder volume when the piston is at TDC to do minimum cylinder volume when the piston is at TDC. That is ratio of swept volume and clearance volume. Mean piston speed UP bar is equal to 2LN by 60. Mean piston speed is often used as an appropriate parameter than crankshaft rotational speed for correlating engine behavior as a function of speed. Mean piston speed determines the instantaneous flow rate of air fuel into the cylinder during intake and exhaust flow out of the cylinder. Higher piston speeds would require larger valves to allow for higher flow rates. In most engines, valves are at a maximum size with no room for enlargement. Now let us derive relation for piston speed to mean piston speed ratio and see what insight we get from it. Assume piston displacement y is equal to l plus a minus s, where s is equal to a cos theta plus l square minus a square sin square theta whole power 1 by 2. When piston is at TDC, s is equal to l plus a. Cylinder volume at any crank angle is v equal to vc plus ac into y, which can be further simplified using above relations as vc plus pi b square by 4 into l plus a minus s. Swept volume vd is equal to pi b square by 4 into l, and average piston velocity up bar is equal to 2ln. We know instantaneous piston velocity up is equal to ds by dt, and finally we get up by up bar is equal to pi by 2 into sin theta into 1 plus cos theta by l plus a whole square minus sin square theta whole power 1 by 2. Average piston speed for automobile engine is 15 meter per second, ultimately limited by material strength. Therefore, engine with larger strokes run at lower speeds than those with smaller strokes run at higher speeds. Let's see effect of R on piston velocity. R is the ratio of connecting rod length to crank offset and usually has values of 3 to 4 for small engines and increasing up to 5 to 10 for bigger engines. Torque. It is the turning effort about the crankshaft axis of rotation. It is equal to product of force acting along the connecting rod and the perpendicular distance between this force and center of rotation of the crankshaft. Brake power. Usable power delivered by the engine measured at the engine output shaft, and this is called brake power because this is measured using brake dynamometer. Brake power BP is equal to tau into 2 pi n by 60. Brake power is always less than the power produced inside the cylinders. Indicated power increases with engine speed while brake power increases to a maximum and then decreases. This is because friction power increases with engine speed and becomes dominant at higher speeds. As engine speed increases, torque reaches a maximum and then decreases. This is because engine is unable to ingest a full charge of air at higher speeds. Pressure inside the cylinder of engine varies considerably during the cycle. Peak pressure occurs just after the TDC and it drops as the piston moves downward. When quoting the cylinder, it is therefore more helpful to refer to the average pressure or mean effective pressure through the whole power stroke. If the power is brake power, then it is called brake mean effective pressure, and if it is indicated power, then it is called indicated mean effective pressure. This is how mean effective pressure can be used to simplify the graphs. That is, a constant pressure is assumed to act upon the system, which does the same work as varying pressure cycle, assuming all other conditions remaining same, that is, swept volume, clearance volume, compression ratio, etc. Maximum brake pressure, brake mean effective pressure is obtained at wide open throttle at a particular engine speed. Closing the throttle decreases BMEP. For a given displacement, a higher brake mean effective pressure means more torque. For a given torque, a higher maximum brake mean effective pressure means smaller engine. Higher maximum BMEP means higher stresses and temperatures in the engine, hence shorter engine life or bulkier engine.